some fun and we'll sing some songs. Music makes me so happy and free. Hello, hello again. Hello, hello again. Hello, hello again. Welcome back to music. Hello, fourth grade. Welcome back to another exciting music class with me, Mr. Houchin. It's really good to see you all, and thank you for joining me here yet again for another exciting round of music. Let's take a look at what I have in store for you today. Taking a look at our schedule here, we're going to start with our Hello Song and Warmup like always, and then move on to Home on the Range, and then pair that up with another song, a new song called Homes in Montana, and then I'm going to share some of your Chrome Music Lab creations that you made. Awesome job. And then we'll finish off with our Musician of the Month before we say goodbye. Now, our goals for today. First part, continue singing our Home on the Range, but doing it while we keep a beat in three. Should be a little bit of a throwback to third grade. And then begin learning our new song, Home in Montana. And then share and compose a new piece for me in Chrome Music Lab. I'll give you another concept or idea. All right, but right now, let's quickly warm ourselves up. And I thought we could warm ourselves up with one of our favorite chorus warm-ups. And it goes like this. Dwee-a-bobaloo, 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 bobaloo, dwee. Dwee-a-bobaloo, 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 bobaloo, dwee. You guys should be pretty good at your tongue twisters from our Pick a Little, Talk a Little. And so really, let's focus on getting nice, good pronunciation when we say dwee-a-bobaloo. I want to hear all the D sounds and B sounds and L sounds when we sing. Dwee-a-bobaloo, 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 bobaloo-dwee. That last one is we sort of switch it around. And we sing that going up and down the scale, like this. Dwee-a-bobaloo, 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 bobaloo-dwee. Dwee-a-bobaloo, 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 bobaloo-dwee. Let's go a little higher. Dwee-a-bobaloo, dwee-a-bobaloo, dwee. Let's go a little higher. How about a little higher? And one more for good measure. Nice job. Do a big sigh with your voice off the top. And now how about just a sigh like you're getting out of bed. Nice big stretch. Arms out to the side. Stretch arms out to the other side. All right. And why don't we just dive on in to our song for today. And last week we started learning Home on the Range. And so if you feel like you've got it, you're doing good with the song and you can sing it with me, let's hear it. If not, we'll practice it one more time today. Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Home, home on the range, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Nice job, nice job. Repeat after me. Home, home on the range. Your turn. Home, home on the range. Nice job. Where the deer and the antelope play. Go. Where the deer and the antelope play. My turn. Where seldom is heard a discouraging word. Where seldom is heard the discouraging word. And the skies are not cloudy and the skies are not cloudy all day. Let's try that part right there, the home on the range part. Home on the range, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Nice job. All right, I think we should try the whole song one more time together before moving on today. So let's start with the beginning with "Oh, Give Me a Home," and then we'll sing the chorus, "Home, Home on the Range." All right, and really do your best to be singing along with me, starting up nice, and it is a little bit high, you know, but get up into your high singing voice. Needs a little bit of a workout. It's probably been missing all that hard work we've been doing in school lately, so go ahead and try it for me. Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Home, home on the range, where the deer discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Nice job. Great singing. Thanks for singing with me, by the way. So, I'm going to change scenes there. Are the right thing up? Let's see. Ah, here we go. Uh-oh, gotta move my hat up a little higher. There we go, that fits a little better. So, there's another song that sort of fits this same idea, same feeling as Home on the Range. And it's called My Home's in Montana. And it's a little similar to Home on the Range, and we'll see how they sort of fit together. And I'll be honest, it's a little bit of a new song to me, so I'm trying my best. But if I make some mistakes, that's okay. You're not going to tell anybody, are you? Okay. My home's in Montana. I wear a bandana. My spurs are of silver. My pony is gray. Whatever the weather, we travel together with foot in the stirrup, a gallop. Like that. Now I'll tell you, when I like to sing this song, I actually like to change the word Montana to Arizona, because you guys know me, I'm originally from Arizona, and we have a lot of horse riding and cowboys out there. In fact, my brother is a cowboy. He lives and works on a ranch, and his job is to ride horses all day in the hot desert sun. So I'm going to change the Montana to Arizona for the sake of at least when I sing it. You can sing Montana, you can sing Arizona, you can sing Somerville if you want. All right, but repeat after me. My home's in Arizona. My home's in Arizona. I wear a bandana. I wear a bandana. Let's see. Spurs, there we go. My spurs are of silver. My spurs are of silver. My spurs are of silver. My pony is gray. Sorry, I'm trying to change around the octaves here, and I think I might have messed up a little bit. I'm just going to sing the first couple of lines again and see if I can fix this. Oh my gosh, Mr. Houchin, you're on YouTube. You can't be making mistakes like this, can you? Now everybody's going to see my mistakes and they're going to laugh at me. Let's try it. My home's in Montana, I wear a bandana. My spurs are of silver, my pony is gray. My spurs are... There we go. My spurs are of silver, my pony is gray. There we go. My spurs are of silver, my pony is gray. Would you sing that? My spurs are of silver, my pony is gray. I knew I'd get it. All right. Next part, repeat after me. Whatever the weather, whatever the weather, we travel together, we travel together, with foot in the stirrup, with foot in the stirrup. Ooh, let me try that again. Huh, Mr. Houchin. With foot in the stirrup. That's better. With foot in the stirrup, we'll gallop all day. Just like that. Let me sing that whole last line for you. Oh my gosh. If you guys are just watching this laughing at me how bad of a job I'm doing, that's okay. With foot in the stirrup, I'll gallop all day. Your turn. With foot in the stirrup, I'll gallop all day. All right. Let's try this whole thing together. Now, if you have a little trouble singing this, don't worry. So do I. But let's try it for just for fun. My home's in Arizona. That's not correct. One more time. My home, just like that. My home's in Arizona. I wear a bandana. My spurs are a silver. My pony is gray. Whatever the weather, we travel together. With footsteps to syrup, I'll gallop all day. Something close like that. You know what? Let's give the song a week. I'm sure by next week, I'll have learned it, and then you'll have learned it. Okay? Mr. Houchin, you're a mess. I know. This quarantine's been hard on us all. But let's go ahead and take a break from that song, and let's jump to our Chrome Music Lab sharing that we did from last time. So last week, I gave you a challenge of creating a Chrome Music Lab piece, and the only thing that I asked you to do was make it happy. And whatever that meant to you is okay. And I got a wide range of interpretations of making a happy song on Chrome Music Lab. And thank you to those of you who shared with me on your Google Classroom. Thanks for doing your homework. I appreciate it. So I have some examples of some different compositions and creations that you guys created. So the first comes from Maggie. And let's check out Maggie's piece of music. Oh, I'm going to put my headphones on so I can hear it. And let's take a listen to Maggie's piece. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. It actually has a really nice melody to it. It's sort of, there's a lot of repetition, which is really good when we're creating our songs. And I really like the drum beat. It sort of helps kind of solidify the song. And I feel happy. Let's listen to that again. I like that one a lot. I could see playing that on the recorder. That's cool. All right, our next one comes from our friend Lucy. Nice. So as you can see, Lucy went for a little more of a visual interpretation of a happy song, and that's awesome. But what I think is cool is when you're creating these sort of visual representations of happy, how the music sort of sounds and feels. And frankly, that sounds pretty good. It's a little dissonant in some parts, but I think, you know, overall, we could say that that's pretty happy music. Let's move on to Layla's. All right. Now this one, as we can tell, kind of pattern-based with the colors. And that's pretty cool. And you know what? The way it sort of is repetitive and kind of drones on, it kind of puts you in a little bit of a trance. You can maybe do like kind of like a happy trance dance as you go to it. Really nice job, Layla. And our last one is our friend Gabe. All right. Nice job. Gabe uses a couple of things with his piece. The first off is he changed the drum sound to the conga sound, and he changed the tempo. He made the tempo really fast. And I think the combination of using the conga drum and the fast tempo really make that one kind of cool. Let's listen to that one more time. All right, I like that. So thank you to all of you who, you know, created a piece and submitted it. I know I couldn't share all of them during class, but thank you to those of you who did it. I'm going to give you one more challenge with Chrome Music Lab. And this is to tell a story with sound. Tell a story with sound. How do you do that? I don't know. Now, I want you to go in and play around with the settings. You notice over here, there's a little gear icon that says settings. You can actually make your pieces longer. So if you're trying to tell a little bit of a longer story, try that. And when you post the link to Google Classroom, maybe you can leave a little bit of an explanation of what your story is about. So your next assignment with Chrome Music Lab, tell me a musical story. All right. Well, I think it's about time to spend a little bit more time with our May Musician of the Month. And today is the last time that we're going to talk about our friend Freddie Mercury. Now, when you think of Freddie Mercury and you think of Queen, there's probably one song that everybody thinks of, and that is Bohemian Rhapsody. Bohemian Rhapsody was this epic rock song that features, you know, rock guitars, amazing singing, drums, but it also features elaborate piano parts, operatic singing, and dramatic storytelling. And these are things that aren't necessarily always found in rock music. In fact, when it was first came out, people didn't think it was going to do very well. It was really long. And it had all these extra elements that weren't in rock music. People thought it was going to be too showy and too flashy. But I think they proved them wrong. And it's shown up in a lot of different places. It's shown up in movies, TV, all over. There's lots of different musical tributes to it. So I thought I'd share with you one of my favorite actual tributes to Bohemian Rhapsody. And this is a performance of the song by our friends, the Muppets. Enjoy.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. I'm just a poor boy, I need no sympathy. 'Cause I'm easy come, easy go, little high, little low. Any way the wind blows doesn't really matter to me.
Dada? Dada! I see a little silhouette of a clam. Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango?
Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening.
Me, 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 me.
Galileo.
Me, 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 me.
Galileo, Galileo, Figaro.
I'm just a poor boy, nobody loves me.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family, sparing his life from this
monstrosity! No, no, no.
Easy come, easy go, will you let me go?
Ma, na, ma, na.
Let me throw!
Ooh. Ma, na, ma, na.
They will not let you throw.
Let me blow!
Ma, na, ma, na.
They will not let you blow.
Let me jump!
Do not like your jokes!
Let me jump!
Do not like your jokes!
Let me jump!
No, 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 no! For Nigiri, for Nigiri!
Mamma mia, let me go!
Does anyone know if there is a vibe for me? For me, for me!
So they tell us this video's going too fast!
Scooter?
Yeah, Chief?
Remind me to stop setting up these video conferences. They're not very productive.
You got it.
Sheesh.
I don't know, that feels like some of my meetings. All right, well, hope you enjoyed that. Hope you enjoyed Freddie Mercury and Queen for the month of May. If you haven't been listening to Queen this month, I highly recommend go listen to all their stuff. It's amazing. All right. Unfortunately, that's our time, fourth graders, so thank you again for tuning in, and I'll see you next week. But until then, goodbye, goodbye, my friends. Goodbye, goodbye, my friends. Goodbye, goodbye, my friends. Thank you for music. Goodbye, fourth grade. Adios.